we welcome all our old girls, past and present staff members, past principals, those who hold the Premier Award of the school, the Freedom of Riebeeck College, parents, and of course our current Riebeeck girls, to this online celebration of the founding of our school 144 years ago. Founders Day celebrations were started in 1988 by my mother-in-law, Mrs. Natalie Steer, and 2020 was the first time that these celebrations were not held. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the country was in hard lockdown, but we managed to have a few celebrations on our social media platforms. Little did we know that a year later we would still be in the grips of this virus and be celebrating online again in 2021. In this online Founders Day celebration, I would like to address with a verbal and visual tour of our news and the school. I'm sure this will bring back some fond memories for our old girls. Here, messages from our junior head girl, Raisa Abrahams, and from our senior head girl, Wadley Miller, and you will be treated to some delightful singing of the school song and another song called This Is Me by a group of grade 11 girls, and be shown some rowdy and enthusiastic classes. I hope you are sitting back and enjoying the 2021 Founders Day with us as we wish the grand old lady, that is Riebeeck College, a happy birthday. I'm sure that you're aware that this past year has been a most challenging one in educational circles internationally. The entire face of schooling and education did a 180-degree turn, and educators and learners were forced to engage with teaching and learning in an entirely new way. Gone were sports and extramurals. Gone were tuck shop treats, school uniforms, second breaks, register classes, assemblies, prayer meetings, physical education classes, celebratory days such as house days and prize giving. A new era had dawned, and in came social distancing, masks, sanitizers, new timetables, large classroom venues or split classes, one-way corridors, civvies, platooning with some grades at home for a bit every now and again, queuing to have your temperature taken by a thermal scanner, screening forms, toilet registers for track and trace purposes. With this came heightened anxiety, loneliness and insecurity. However, the traits that make the Riebeeck family stand out also came to the fore, and we saw resilience, compassion, adaptability, tenacity and independence come to the fore, and we're so proud of the way that we all rose to the challenges posed, with some demonstrating these positive traits in extremely trying circumstances. We reached the end of 2020 exhausted, but with the feeling that we had made it through to the other side. As Noreen Luke, our consulting psychologist, put it, we have seen the finish line and put in a last push to get to it, only to have the finish line moved, and we had to start the race over. So it was that 2021 heralded more safety precautions with a second wave of the pandemic and fears of a third wave, and we resumed schooling in the same manner in which we ended in 2020. To keep our spirits buoyant, we adopted the theme of the year, Hope Floats. Without hope, we are lost. So at Riebeeck, we are kept afloat by the hope inside of us. When you have hope, you have possibilities. In order for us to believe in the future and to step into it with confidence, we need the support of those nearest and dearest to us. Then hope floats. Pope Francis wisely said recently, to be happy is to find strength in forgiveness, hope in battles, security in the stage of fear, love in discord. It is not only to enjoy the smile, but also to reflect on the sadness. It is not only to celebrate the successes, but to learn lessons from the failures. It is not only to feel happy with the applause, but to be happy when anonymous. It is my hope that we will take the lessons learnt from the pandemic and use them to create a better world. It is evident that we cannot return to the world as it was before. The pandemic did expose the inequalities in education, not only in South Africa, but throughout the world. The digital divide revealed that educational institutions that were fortunate to be digitally literate with access to internet, the Wi-Fi and data could continue to educate remotely. This deepened this divide. One of the strongest messages coming through since the start of the pandemic is that our common humanity necessitates global solidarity. The magnitude of this challenge is clearly evident with regard to the digital divide in Africa. For example, only 11% of learners in sub-Saharan Africa have a household computer, and only 18% have household internet, as compared to the 50% of learners globally who have computers in the home and 57% who have access to internet. South Africa is lagging behind in becoming active participants in a world where digital learning has become the new norm. The COVID-19 pandemic does offer us a chance to restructure education in such a way as to be inclusive of the needs of all learners. Inclusive and quality education is one of the most powerful means to achieve sustainable development. This makes it important to adequately equip the country's education system and enable it to respond to the changing needs of teaching and learning. Educator roles have to be transformed, and educators have to adapt to a new pedagogical concepts and ways of delivering teaching, for which they might not have been trained. To be able to respond to the needs of society and education, teaching offerings will need to be revisited. If this chance to restructure education for the benefit of all children is missed, the education crisis will worsen, and the disparity between privileged and impoverished pupils become even more noticeable. Here at Rubik, we must make sure that we keep moving forward and that we will remain relevant in all that we do. I can honestly say that I am proud when I think of the ways the teachers and learners structured their work in ways that worked for us. WhatsApp, YouTube clips, PowerPoints, audio voice notes and crash courses all became our new normal as we made sure our learners could learn with the minimum of data and with the knowledge that they were not alone. Their teachers were even willing to learn to use Zoom and Teams to teach them, or whatever method it took. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the old girls who generously made donations towards the cost of our sanitization and masks. Times are tight, and our budget is stretched tight, so help from the old girls means so much to us. We thank you too for your continued support of our endeavours, your encouragement on our social media platforms of our girls and staff, and the difference you are making in the community by spreading the Rubik magic formula of compassion, positivity, confidence, empathy and innovation. Please keep sharing your good news with us and enjoy our nostalgic posts on our social media platforms and websites. One of the songs you will be hearing in this video is a unique harmonizing by our girls of the song This Is Me from The Greatest Showman. And I say to you, as the song lyrics do, I won't let them break me down to dust. I know there's a place for us, for we are glorious. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, because here I come, and I'm marching onto the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen, I make no apologies. This is me. And so, it is that this is us, this is Rubik. It is in the belief that hope lies in dreams, in imagination, and in the courage of those who dare to make dreams into reality. At this Founders Day 2021, I wish for you courage and hope. Stay safe and happy. Happy birthday to us.
I'm not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want a broken heart. I've learned to be a sailor of all my flaws. Run away, they say, no one will love you for too long. But won't let them break me down to
of 2021. Today we'll be doing things a little bit differently, so sit back, relax, and enjoy this video. Being in junior school for almost 4 years now, I've definitely had a lot of fun. Junior school at Rubik College is so fun-filled and full of such amazing events, from Stay Awake to the Mini Fun Gala, and having such amazing teachers as well. Running to the tuck shop break times is definitely a highlight of most people's day. The highlight of junior school for me is definitely seeing my friends and classmates, and also having this amazing opportunity of doing this speech this year as well. But with the current pandemic, everything has changed. Suddenly, there was sanitizing, wearing masks, social distancing, and not even being able to give our teachers hugs anymore. Many events have been cancelled, from grade 7 camp and prefect camp as well. When we come back for our 10-year reunion, I hope to see many of my old teachers, old classmates, and some of the bright faces of the new Rubik learners. I hope that the tuck shop will still be there, the break time benches, and I hope that the classrooms don't change too much. Lastly, I would like to wish all the old girls well, and I hope that they flourish in everything that they would still like to do and are doing. I hope that you all stay safe and enjoy this video. Ora et labora will always stand the test.
All hail be to our college, the college we all know. Her good name will follow wherever we may go. In times of need, remember that all she stands for best.
Of where we have come from and how we as a school have grown throughout the years. I remember it to be a day that holds so much reminiscing of past years and reuniting it with new ones. There would always be plenty of old girls who attended in the reunion groups, and a game of hockey between the first team players would play against the current first team players. But I'm sure most learners would remember the donuts and the juice received from the school. Although this year it may be different, but to me, what remains true is the memories Founders Day holds. We may not be able to meet all together in person, but our memories will last forever. What we can stand firm on is the fact of once a Rebic girl, always a Rebic girl, no matter the circumstance. Since our reunion groups are not visiting us this year, I would like to share with you what has been happening at our school since March 2020. We started the year 2020 with the theme of What a Wonderful World. And what a time to have been reminded of how precious our world is and how we should appreciate it more, because now we know how instantly things may turn upside down. That turning point for us was in March 2020, when the uprising of the coronavirus took us all by shock and we as a nation had entered lockdown. Our national family meetings with President Cyril Ramaphosa kept everyone informed about the pandemic. On the other hand, at Rebic, Mrs. Steer and the staff, through the school's social media platforms, kept in touch with the girls throughout the time of uncertainty, in trying to bring us as much clarity on how the future would look for our school. The Rebic staff and learners indeed adapted to this new way of living and learning with true Rebic resilience. Though we were apart from one another, the teachers and learners were thankfully still able to remain connected through the school's D6 communicator, cross WhatsApp groups and Zoom calls. In 2020, Rebic welcomed 7 new members to the family: Mrs. Haynes Africa, Mr. Vincent Cookamore, Ms. Oliphant, Ms. Tana, Mrs. Hoyman, Mr. Hartley and Mrs. Carstens. Finally, in June 2020, the integration of the Machiks and Grade 7s took place, and then gradually on a week off and on basis, the rest of the other grades were integrated. It was during this time that sanitizing stations, screening forms, and face masks became mandatory. The Rebic staff adjusted to these requirements so effortlessly by seeking ways to make our adaptation to this new norm as comfortable as possible. Learners would have less venues to attend, as our teachers would have moved between lessons to ensure less contact and more social distancing. Throughout this year, many things were taken away, but some things remained and just had to be adjusted to our new circumstances. Our cultural service day and the club assembly were held online, the Machik 40 days were celebrated safely, and the SPCA committee had their tin collections at the end of the year in supporting the SPCA with the donations collected. The year 2020 was indeed a tough year for our 2020 Machiks, who endured through many months of studying at home on their own. However, through it all, they persevered, and we are proud to announce Rebec's 98.9% pass rate. Congratulations to our top achievers, to Neil Rudman with 7 distinctions, Azra Rockman with 5 distinctions, and Sunny Siwe Dili with 4 distinctions. What a way to enter the year of 2021 with so much hope from the achievements of the class of 2020 that displayed pure Rebic resilience. Although we find ourselves in a new year living in a pandemic, hope still floats. There are still limited grades at our school per week, but we are continuing to adapt and giving hope a chance to float up. The highlights thus far for 2021 is the grade 4 welcoming that was planned by the 2021 senior prefects. The gradual return of sports is coming into place, the 2021 prefects induction was held, and committees are introducing exciting online campaigns. These developments are evident to our theme this year of Hope Floats. So let us continue to hope in 2021, as in the words of Barack Obama. Hope in the face of difficulty. Hope in the face of uncertainty. The audacity of hope. In the end, that is God's greatest gift to us. A belief in things not seen. A belief that there are better days ahead. In closing, I wish you all safety and good health, and may you remember to give hope a chance to float up throughout this year. Thank you.
Rebec College Girls High School was established in 1877 and holds dear her traditions while embracing change and progressive actions that drive our warm, embracing ethos. Our 2021 theme is Hope Floats, in recognition that in times of change, chaos and abnormality, we need to cling to hope that there will be happier and better times ahead.
Pope Francis said, "We reaffirm our conviction that fraternity is more durable than fratricide, that hope is more powerful than hatred, that peace is more powerful than war." COVID-19 safety protocols required us to reimagine schooling. Our bigger venues became classrooms. Our timetable became streamlined with a slower pace so we could focus on safety and academics. We learned how to work smart, how to make each minute count within the rotational system for grades 5 to 11, and we learned the power of kindness in tough times.
We have great hopes for our school and bold hopes for our girls as they progress from school children to leaders in their communities. At Rebec, we carry hope for every child in our core and every young lady and old girl who has passed through our door. We hope you'll join us in spreading positivity, clarity, and hope in these seemingly hopeless times. Our hope is in you.
Darling girl, hold your head up high. Look, this life's wearing the eye. Yourself and everyone else. Don't mess around with the lies. You're beautiful, I hope you love the skin that your precious soul is dressed up in. Remember to choose a smile when you lose and poise when you win. And I hope you never forget. You were brave, you were strong, you were smart, and I love you with all my heart. And oh, there will never be girl.